Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro Partner. Today I'm going to show how we can segment our Mailchimp audience. Our audience, of course, is the place in Mailchimp that we add our contacts, their email addresses, and so on. The way we then divide up, I guess, our audience is by something called segments. We can then target our marketing. So for example, if you had the gender of people and you wanted to target people based on the on a certain gender, you could do that by creating a segment. Let's go across to Mailchimp. I'm in Mailchimp, I'm viewing my audience. So all I've done is if you don't see your audience, you can click audience. I'm going to view all my contacts. Now I could click all contacts or click over here, the button here called view contacts. So as soon as this loads, you'll notice I've got various people or contacts in my audience. I've got their data as well. And in other of my videos, I've described how in most Mailchimp plans, depending on what plan you're on, you can have 30 columns of or 30 fields of data and an unlimited number of tags, the only restriction being 100 characters per tag. So once we've got all our data into Mailchimp, into our Mailchimp audience, we can target our marketing by using segments again. So, for example, let's view all people that are repeat customers. So, looking at my audience, we know that people are repeat customers because in the repeat customer field, they have a Y. So, let's create a segment. A segment is effectively just a search of our data. So, as long as our data are in Mailchimp, we can search on it or we can filter on it. So what we're looking for is repeat customer is Y, and that'll give me all my repeat customers. So all I do is I click new segment. So I've clicked new segment, and then we just build our search in this case. So this here where it says email marketing status, if I click on that, you'll notice that all my fields and various other data are shown, tags, etc. So what I said is I want the repeat customer field, so I'll just click on that. And what I wanted is where my repeat customer field is Y. And it's not case sensitive, by the way. And then I'll click preview segment. And you'll notice that now all these people have a Y in this column. So my segment has worked. If my criteria were not correct, it just didn't look right, I could click edit segment. Alternately, I'll just click save segment. And I can call it whatever I want to. Let's call it this repeat customers, for example. You can call it whatever you want. It doesn't matter. And I'll click save. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to click all contacts again just to refresh my audience. And I'll just go out of my segment by clicking the cross. What you'll notice is now when I click on view segment, my segment is there, my search is there. So forevermore, and you can have as many segments as you want, you can create as many segments as you want, it will be there. And it's dynamic in nature in that as people or our contacts meet the criteria, they'll fall into the segment, or if they don't, they'll fall out. So if today I create the segment called repeat customers or whatever you call it, then tomorrow I add someone who has a Y in the repeat customer field, they'll be in the segment. And conversely, if someone doesn't have a Y anymore in the repeat customer field, they won't fall into that segment. And just to be more precise, the segment, if you're doing email marketing, the segment itself is calculated at the point of time of sending. So this is important because let's say we schedule an email to go out next week Thursday. The segment or people that fall into that segment will be calculated next week Thursday. Not today when you schedule it, but next week Thursday. Okay, so that was a fairly simple segment. And think of segments as well as how we can use one audience in Mailchimp rather than multiple audiences. Sorry, we can use one audience, we add the various data, and we divide them up we into segments, as it were. But let's get a bit more fancy, I guess. Not complex, but fancy. Let's say we want all repeat customers who have a tag of USA. So two criteria, I want repeat customers, so where there's a Y under repeat customers, and USA in the tags field. Let's create a new segment. I'll click new segment. You'll notice that down the bottom, we have an add where we can add another search criteria into our segment. So what I said is my first criteria, I wanted to be repeat customer. So where my repeat customer is Y. Of course, I could have changed the search here to be, for example, is not or contains or is not blank or something like that. But where my repeat customer is Y, and I said I want my tag to be USA. And my tag, so let me scroll down, find tags, and my tag, contact is tagged. So contact is tagged USA. So these will be all people who are repeat customers are Y, and the tag is USA. Just be a little bit aware of this up here, contacts match. It can be any, so that, or it can be all, so that and that. So you can play with that if your results aren't correct. Okay, preview segment. So I'm expecting to see all people who have a Y in the repeat customer field and a tag of the USA. Absolutely correct. Let's save the segment and I can call it anything I want. Let's call it repeat customers in u.s.a. Okay, and save. And of course that will now be there for the future. So at any time I can use my entire audience or a segment to target my marketing. I certainly hope this has helped you. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel. My name is Gary from organicweb.com.au.